Hello everyone, in this session we'll discuss about third program of design and analysis of algorithm laboratory. Write a Java program to read two integers a and b, compute a by b, a divided by b, and print when b is not zero. Write an exception when b is equal to zero. Yes, so here execution starts from main method. Yes, that is main. Here we have main class. Lab3A is a main class. So before move on to the programming part, you need to know exception handling. What is exception handling? So if say for example, okay, if I take this example only, here we have, what is the program? Compute A by B. If A is equal to 20 and B is equal to 10, what is the answer? It is 2. Right, so you should know, okay, being a programmer, you should know what end user might enter. Okay, for example, if the end user can enter any value, right? So he can enter 0 or minus 1, minus 2, various different values. But here b is what, if b is equal to, if end user enters b as 0, okay, if end user enters b is equal to 0, then what happens? It's a it is an error, right? Divided by 0 error, exception. So denominator is 0, that error has to be displayed. So that is why we use exception handling to guide the end user to correct his or her mistake. Okay, so exception handling, or it's also called as error handling. Okay, exception handling is used to tell the end user to correct the mistake, okay, to correct the mistake and what mistake he has done and how to fix that error. Okay, you had to tell the end user. So that that is where exception handling comes into picture. Yes, so lab3a class, and the main execution starts from main method. Yes, lab3a is a main class. And a scanner class. It's a scanner class used to accept the input from the keyboard. Why did we create this object of scanner class? Because we are using a nextin method, non-static nextin method. Of this nextin method is non-static method of scanner class. So this is the object. In object is used to access the non-static method nextin, right? And so this is what will happen. Enter the value of a. So it waits for this when instruction pointer is pointing to this particular line of the code, then what happens? It will wait for user input. So if you enter 20, that 20 gets stored in variable a, which is declared as int. Yes, and again so you cannot enter 20.3 decimal points and at all, because it is declared as integer only. So you had to enter the integer value only. So here system enter the value of b. Yes. So int b is equal to, in again it wait for user input, then b is equal to 10. So 10 is what, integer. So compute c is equal to new compute. So compute is not a inbuilt class, it is user defined class. Here we are passing two parameters, right? What are the parameters? 20 and 10 are the parameters we are passing. So as soon as you create the object, constructor block gets executed. So which is constructor block here? Here we have constructor block. Okay, so constructor, as soon as you create the object, constructor block gets executed. So here we have constructor block. Yes, so we have created the object or instance of compute class, right? So then this block gets executed, and this constructor is is declared as public. Means what? You can access this compute constructor block outside the class. Also outside the compute class. So this dot a is equal to 20. So since we have two a's, right, here we have a and here also we have a, that is why so we are using this keyword. Means what? This is an instance or object of compute class used to access private members of compute class. Okay, this keyword is used to access private variables of compute class. Okay, so a is equal to 20 and b is equal to 10. This 20 is assigned to this dot a, that is this one, this a, and b is equal to 10 it is assigned to this dot b, that is private variable b. Okay, so this is what a is equal to 20 and b is equal to 10. After that, once this constructor block gets executed, again it will execute the next instruction, that is c dot compute a by b. Compute a by b is what? It is a non-static method of compute class. Okay, since it is a non-static method, you had to access, you can access this compute a by b method using object of compute class, which is c. So we had to use c dot dot operator as c dot compute a by b, right? So now where is that compute a by b? It's here. Public, it is declared as public and it is of void type. Return type is void because we are not returning any value here, right? Then now we have try and catch. So try and catch this, then means what? If we have try and catch keywords in our program, then it is a we are using exception handling concepts. So what is a try and catch? Then inside this try block you can perform valid computation, whatever it is, mathematical or logical computations, you can perform computations inside try block. If you want to tell the end user to correct his or her mistake, then type it inside catch block. Okay, so that the end user can correct the mistake and also he can fix the error. So next, what is that error now? That in this example, b is equal to 0, right? If b is equal to 0, it is divided by 0. Then display that error message inside catch block. That's it. So try is to perform computational purpose, and catch is to display the or tell the end user to fix the error, to correct the error, or to tell the tell what error, what is that error? Okay. So now what is the first, we'll see try block. If this dot b, okay, that is this dot, why we are using this keyword here? Because we are accessing a non-static method b of, that is private variable of compute class. Since it's a non-static variable, this a and b are non-static variable, you had to use this keyword, this dot b. Okay, object, this is what, object of compute class. This dot b is not equal to 0, so what is the, what we have entered? 10, right? So b is equal to 10, so it's not equal to 0. So it is what? System dot out dot print, it will perform operation, division operation, that is float. Here we are using typecasting, because a is also integer, b is also integer, so the result will be integer, right? So for example, 20 by 10 is what? 2. It is not a decimal, we don't have any decimal point. What if we, if I enter 20 divided by 3, it is we'll get decimal points, right? Obviously we'll get decimal points. So that is why we use what? Typecasting here. Float of, keep it inside the bracket and into 1.0 into and multiply it with the result a by b, right? So to get the decimal points, to retain the decimal points. So it's all about try block. Yes, else, and else throw. Okay, if b is not equal, if b is equal to 0, if denominator is 0, then display the error message. Means what? You had to guide the end user to correct the mistake. Yes, throw is the keyword. Use the keyword throw space new my exception. Here we are using what is that? Creating the instance of my exception class, new my exception. What happens? So this particular block, where is that my exception class? Here we have my exception class. This block gets executed. So my exception is a user defined class. It is not inbuilt class. Okay, it is user defined class. You can give any name for this. Here we have used my exception, and extends inheritance concept, right? Extends exception. This is inbuilt class. Exception is inbuilt class, and my exception is not inbuilt class. It's user defined class. And in this my exception class, we have two string method. This two string method, we are overriding. We are overriding two string method, which belongs to, this two string method belongs to exception class. Okay, so since we are overriding this two string method, we have to use inheritance concept, that is extend space exception. So this two string is declared as string because we are returning What is the return type here? Denominator is 0 divided by 0. Is divided by 0 exception, correct? It is a it is declared as public. Even if you don't declare it as public, you'll get the output. Okay, so you can access this constructor. This is what now? It is a constructor overriding. So we are using toString method, means what? Overriding the method of exception class. Okay, so now what happens? So now make use of this my exception class inside catch parenthesis. In this catch parenthesis, we had to that name and this name should be same. Okay, my exception, that class name and this name should be same. Space E. This is what exception error. This what exception or error. So in this we are printing the error message. What is that message? This particular block gets executed. What is that? Return denominator or is 0 divided by 0 exception. So this block gets executed. Yes. This block gets executed, so it will display the error message. So let us execute this program. Lab 3A, save, and let me use toString, right? So let me run this program. Enter value of A, enter the value of A, 20 and 10. A result 20 by 10, which is 2.0. We are getting 2.0 now. Yes. So what if I remove this float? As I said, I'll show you the typecasting also. This typecasting here. Yes. Float 1.0, right? I'll just remove this part. Okay. I'll have removed this typecasting. Now we'll see 0.0 will not it will not be shown. Okay. And 20, 10. So now it is showing only 2. So if it is 20 by 3, so answer is 6. Actual answer is what? 6.666, right? But here we are getting 6 only because it is point decimal points will be truncated. So that is why we use float, keep it inside the parentheses and 1.0 and multiply it with the result. So now it will show the decimal points. Save this and I'll run this. Yes. So 20 and 3. So answer is 6.6666, right? So that is why we use this one. And one more thing, here, as I said, exception handling, this one is not required here. However, I'm not used here. So in this here, we have used exception, right? Even if you don't use that, it won't affect the output. Okay. Yes. Now let me use this. It will just display the message. That's it. That exception message. So 20 and 0. So exception denominator is 0 divided by 0 exception. Right. Yeah. What error handling or exception handling? So if exception handling means what? Make use of try block and catch block and also throw keyword. So try, catch and throw keyword. Yes. This is what user defined exception means. What user means? What user exception? So there are so many inbuilt exceptions also. You can even make use of those built-in exceptions if you want. So it's all about program 3A. Hope you have understood. If you have any doubt, please comment below. Thank you so much for watching.